Welcome back to the Dynasty Nerds YouTube channel. Marvin Elquin here. You can find me on Twitter at @FF_MarvinE. And for today's video, we get to dive into the Green Bay Packers backfield. And this should be a fun discussion, as most of us probably didn't expect Aaron Jones to re-sign with the Packers. We expected him to sign with the Dolphins or the Bills, or just a different team, really, considering the cap space that the Packers had available. But with him returning, it will affect the Dynasty outlook for both Aaron Jones and AJ Dillon. Regardless, I think both running backs can remain productive in this offense, more so Aaron Jones. So in this video, we'll dive into this backfield as a whole, Jones and Dillon's production and efficiency, and what to expect from both of them in 2021 and beyond. All right, let's dive into this Green Bay Packers backfield. Let's first take a look at the opportunity share for this backfield in 2021. And should not come as a surprise that Aaron Jones led this team in several categories. From a rushing standpoint, Aaron Jones accounted for 53% of the running back rush attempts with 14.4 per game. Jamal Williams was at 31.2% with 8.5 per game. And AJ Dillon at 12.1% with 5.1 rushing attempts per game. If we take a look at the running back target share, Aaron Jones led that category as well, accounting for 54.3% of the running back targets with 4.4 per game. Williams was at 30.7% with 2.5 targets, and Dillon at 1.7% with only 0.2 targets per game. So in his rookie year, he wasn't used heavily as a receiver. But Jones would lead this team with 18.8 opportunities per game at the running back position, with Jamal Williams right there with 11.4. However, Jamal Williams is now a Detroit Lion, so there are some available opportunities there for Jones and for AJ Dillon specifically. A third running back will be involved regardless, but I expect Jones and Dillon to be the RB1 and RB2s for this offense going forward. Now, if we take a look at the individual pieces of this backfield, Aaron Jones is currently being drafted as the RB13 in Dynasty. I have him right there as well, just outside that RB1 range. And in the near future, though, I do believe he has top five running back potential, especially in 2021. And over the last two seasons, he has been one of the more productive running backs in the league. Absolutely impressive from an efficiency and fantasy standpoint. Since 2019, Jones has only averaged 17.7 touches per game. That's good for RB14 in the league. And regardless, even with the not necessarily massive workload, Aaron Jones has been the RB5 in PPR points per game with 19.1. That's behind only Christian McCaffrey, Dalvin Cook, Alvin Kamara, and Derrick Henry. So elite company right there for Aaron Jones. He's also one of only seven running backs to average at least 100 scrimmage yards over the last two seasons. And among all running backs with a minimum of 10 touches per game, Jones ranks as the RB5 in yards per touch with 5.7. Now expect Jones to remain this efficient and productive in this backfield, especially in 2021 with Jamal Williams no longer on the team. And he will not necessarily assume 80% of the running back workload, or even 70%. But what we've seen over the last few seasons is that 50 to 60% of the running back opportunity share, especially if targets go his way, that's more than plenty for Aaron Jones to return weekly RB1 value in 2021 and maybe even in 2022. AJ Dillon, on the other hand, who's now the RB2 for this offense, he received minimal playing time throughout his rookie year. He exceeded 5 touches in only 2 games this past season. And as I mentioned earlier, he averaged about 5.3 opportunities per game, and that's heavily driven by his week 16 breakout. Regardless of the lack of volume, Dillon was actually one of the more efficient running backs in the league. Among running backs with a minimum of 5 opportunities per game, he was the RB6 in yards created per touch with 1.9. That's essentially the yards that a running back gains above what the line has blocked for them. He was also the RB14 in breakaway run rate with 6.5% of his carries going for 15 yards or more. And he was also the RB3 in juke rate, evading a tackle on 6.5% of his touches. And you might be thinking, well, these numbers are bound to go down with more opportunities and volume, right? Well, that didn't actually happen in week 16 when Dillon received 22 touches versus Tennessee. That week, among running backs with a minimum of 5 touches, Dillon was the RB1 with a 54.5% juke rate. He was the RB2 with a 4.5% breakaway run rate, and he was also the RB5 in yards created per touch, finishing the week as the RB6 in PPR points with 25.9. And while those numbers are impressive, we do have to temper our expectations a little bit. Jones dealt with a hip injury that game and played limited snaps, so he likely won't receive 20 touches again unless Jones goes down with an injury. But regardless, it was still impressive to see Dylan take advantage of the opportunities that he received and perform as one of the more efficient running backs in the league. So if we take a look at this offense as a whole and try to project them out for the next couple of years, we have to take a look at the offensive line first. Football Outsiders ranks this Green Bay offensive line at fifth in adjusted line yards in 2020. So a very good offensive line unit, but they do lose Corey Linsley, who was an all-pro center for them in 2020. And he's now with the Los Angeles Chargers after signing a contract with them in free agency. They do get back David Bakhtiari, who was an all-pro left tackle for them. He tore his ACL later in the season. And they do still have Elgton Jenkins, who is their all-pro guard, someone who they can move around the offensive line if needed. But regardless, they will have a hole at center and potentially guard, depending on what they do with Jenkins. So that's something we need to keep an eye on, as that will directly affect Aaron Jones, AJ Dillon, and this backfield as a whole. But for the most part, we can expect a similar offense in 2021 with Aaron Rodgers once again leading this team. And for the next couple of seasons, I do expect Jones to assume the majority of the running back workload, anywhere between the 50 to 60% running back opportunity share. That should be about 18 to 20 touches or opportunities per game. And for AJ Dillon, I do expect him to slot into that change of pace running back role, the role that Jamal Williams had over the last couple of years. That should translate to about 10 to 12 touches per game, which will be a boost for AJ Dillon and his fantasy production. But what I do want to highlight here is Aaron Jones's contract. He will be the guy for the next couple of years, but from 2023 on and going forward, there is an opportunity for the Packers to move on from Jones if they want to give Dillon the keys to this backfield and save some cap space along the way. Jones' contract has a minimal cap hit for 2021 and 2022, so he will be on this team and leading this backfield. But starting in 2023, if he was designated as a post-June 1 cut, the Packers could actually save $16 million in 2023 and $12 million in 2024. And at that point, Jones will be approaching his age 30 season. Dillon will only be 24. And with Dillon approaching a contract year in 2023, it only makes sense for the Packers to take a look at what they have in Dillon and see what he can do with an RB1 workload. And as a result, Jones might be the odd man out, and he might no longer be on the team starting that season, especially if they can save that much cap space. But how should you approach this backfield now going forward for Dynasty? I think Jones still profiles as an RB1 at least for the next couple of years. And that could be a value right now, especially at his RB13 Dynasty ADP. For contenders, he would make an excellent RB1 or RB2, someone who has a really, really high ceiling and can win you games with his upside. But let's not forget AJ Dillon as well, who's being drafted as a flex running back in dynasty leagues. He could be a sneaky trade target for rebuilding teams, as he does project as a flex running back on certain weeks. But I believe his upside could be in the future. If Jones goes down with an injury or is let go in a couple of seasons, Dillon could provide RB1 upside going forward in this Packers offense. All right, hopefully you guys enjoyed this breakdown of the Green Bay Packers backfield. As always, thank you guys so much for tuning in. If you haven't already, check out our rookie breakdowns on the channel. We've been releasing those over the last couple of weeks. And as always, be sure to subscribe, like, hit that notification bell as we help prepare you guys for your 2021 Dynasty seasons.